So thanks be to God for tonight. We thank the Lord for His grace buong araw na nakalipas. Of course, mga kapatiran natin who are listening from abroad, morning pa lang sila, so their day is just starting. Magkaiba tayo ng time zone. But for those of us dito sa Pinas and even sa mga malalapit na bansa, you know, more or less, we're wrapping up the day and we're preparing to sleep. So, I thank the Lord na meron tayong time to, you know, to draw near to the presence of God. And by God's grace, we can center our whole being sa Kanya and really pay attention to what He might want to teach us through His Word. So I would like to encourage you to do that, to pay attention. I-focus natin yung ating buong sarili. Kung kinakailangan, let's use an earphone siguro so that we can focus. At ibaba muna natin kung ano man yung mga ginagawa natin o inasikaso natin, no? For just a few minutes. Let's just focus on God's Word. So every now and then, we will meet difficult people, no? Lahat naman tayo, nakakamit tayo ng mga tao na parang, you know, mahirap pakisamahan for various reasons, no? They tend to give us a lot of stress. So how we wish that they would go away, o kaya we could go away. But sometimes, you know, these types of people are actually living with us or vice versa. So, parang wala tayong escape, no? And that creates even more stress, no? I'm sure. So, how do we deal with difficult people, no? Especially when we cannot get rid of them or we cannot get out of that situation. So, yan ang topic natin tonight before we sleep. Dealing with difficult people. And we're going to look at Psalm 4. Which is kakambal ng Psalm 3 actually. Psalm 3 is more like an morning prayer, and Psalm 4 is really the evening prayer. And usually itong dalawa na to ay nire-recite by believers, you know, all through throughout the centuries. Psalm 3 usually sa umaga, and then Psalm 4 usually sa gabi. So we want to look at Psalm 4. And again, this is written by David. As you can see from the subtitle, for the director of music with stringed instruments, a Psalm of David. So this was composed by David according to the superscription sa Psalm. Pero walang historical na you know, event that is connected to the Psalm, which is why the Psalm is actually, you know, applicable sa lahat ng tao. Because we can all relate to what he's talking about dito sa Psalm na to. He talks about yung burden niya o yung stress niya, because there are people, no, in his life who are oppressing him and speaking lies sa kanya, and you know, na-stress na siya sa mga tao. So let's read that and we'll pray and meditate on it, no, and hear what the Spirit of the Lord wants us to learn tonight. So starting in verse 1, although in the Hebrew Bible this is verse 2, pero since we're using the English Bible, this is verse 1. Sabi nga niya na, "Answer me when I call to you, O my righteous God. Give me relief from my distress. Be merciful to me and hear my prayer. How long, O men, will you turn my glory into shame? How long will you love delusions and seek false gods?" And then there's that word again indicating a pause or a rest, Selah. And then verse 3, know that the Lord has set apart the godly for himself. The Lord will hear when I call to him. In your anger, do not sin. When you are on your beds, search your hearts and be silent. Selah. Offer right sacrifices and trust in the Lord. Verse 6, many are asking, who can show us any good? Let the light of your face shine upon us, O Lord. You have filled my heart with greater joy than when their grain and new wine abound. I will lie down and sleep in peace. For you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety. So I want you to just listen to those words and see if there's any word or phrase na parang ini-impress sa inyo ng Panginoon. So let us pray. Manalangin po tayo. Dear Lord, we come to you tonight before we sleep. We are grateful for the day that has passed. Soon, Lord God, itong araw na to will be over and we would be sleeping in your presence. So, Panginoon, we want to meditate on God's Word. Speak to us, Lord God. Mangusap po kayo, Panginoon. We want to open our hearts to prepare ourselves, O God, for a good night's sleep. Mangusap po kayo, Panginoon, and comfort us. Give us peace, O Lord God. We receive this, Lord, right now sa puso namin, the peace and the joy that comes from your presence. We receive that right now in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. So pag-usapan natin tong psalm na to. Let's meditate on this psalm. I titled this devotion, Dealing with Difficult People, because yun yung nakikita kong parang tema ng psalm na ito. And so I want us to answer the question na how do we deal with difficult people? I don't know about you, pero minsan di ba merong mga tao na parang mahirap pakisamahan, mabigat sa loob, you know? Merong mga tao minsan na parang nakakainis at minsan yung mga salita nila na, you know, na tumatagos sa puso natin at na-offend tayo, nasasaktan tayo. That's exactly what David is talking about dito sa psalm na ito. And this is a prayer. This psalm is actually a prayer. So, I want to look at four prayer items mula dito sa words of this psalm. Upang sa ganun magkaroon din tayo ng, you know, idea on how to deal with difficult people, ano ba ang pwede natin mapag-pray? So the first that I see here is this. Ask God for relief. No? I believe the Lord wants us to come to Him in times of stress and ask for relief. No? So ano ba ibig sabihin yan? Let's look at verses 1 to 3. Sabi ni David, answer me when I call to you, O my righteous God. In other words, like I said, this is a prayer. So, humingi siya ng tulong sa Panginoon. And the way na in-address niya si Lord is righteous God. Ibig sabihin, he's putting his hope na God would do what is right. And then sabi niya, give me relief from my distress. Actually, the Hebrew word relief, no? Stands for space. Kumbaga parang the psalmist, si David, is asking, Lord, bigyan niyo po ako ng space. Nasasakal ako dito sa sitwasyon na ito. And you know that feeling, di ba? Pag may mga tao na parang lagi gusto i-conflict ka, parang laging gusto magkaroon ng di pagkakaunawaan, misa parang nasasakal ka. So, David is asking for relief, no? So in other words, he's asking for space from God. Sabi niya, give me relief from my distress. And then sabi niya, be merciful to me and hear my prayer. So I believe na kapag tayo nakakaramdam ng ganyan mga sitwasyon na, you know, there are people around us na parang napakahirap silang, you know, pakisamahan, mag-relate sa kanila kasi either stubborn sila or hirap sila makaunawa, whatever reason. Si David, itong reason niya, sabi niya sa verse 2, how long, O men, so these are people, no? Hindi ito mga, you know, like soldiers or mga kalaban niya. It's just talking about people. How long, O men, will you turn my glory into shame? So in other words, itong mga taong ito, parang, you know, tinitwist yung mga bagay-bagay para pahiyain siya, you know, para palabasin na, you know, na siya ay may sala or something like that. So sabi niya, how long will you love delusions and seek false gods? We don't know exactly what he's referring to, pero they love delusions. So nag-imagine sila ng mga bagay-bagay. And they seek false gods. In other words, nagtitiwala sila sa mga hindi tunay na Diyos, mga bagay na maaaring pinagmamalaki nila sa sarili nila. Now, we don't know exactly yung detalye ng kanyang pinagdaraanan, pero we can relate to it kasi kaya nga nakalagay dito, Selah, which means think about it. So, madaling salita, you know, when we think about it sa sarili nating mga karanasan, you know, there are people na minsan tinitwist nila yung mga kwento and, you know, gusto nila tayong masaktan o mapahiya, you know, and this can be a situation that creates a lot of stress, di po ba? Pero sabi niya sa verse 3, know that the Lord has set apart the godly for himself. So he's, you know, probably addressing yung mga tao. Sabi niya, you know that the Lord has set apart the godly for himself. So parang dinedeclare niya yung confidence niya na kahit ganun ang ginagawa sa kanya ng mga tao, alam niya na may purpose si Lord sa kanya. Pero the next verse is interesting. Sabi niya, the Lord will hear when I call to Him. In other words, nagsishift yung kanyang focus and bagamat sinasabi niya doon sa mga tao na nag-o-oppress sa kanya na kahit ganyan kayo, the Lord will never abandon me. Parang ganun yung sinasabi niya. Pero at the same time, nako-comfort siya sa sarili niya. Sabi niya, the Lord will hear when I call to Him. So ito yung ibig kong sabihin. This is a prayer that we can pray. I don't know about you, maaaring right now ito yung pinagdaraanan mo. There are people who are just hurting you sa paligid. People na minsan walang pakialam and they're just parang making up stories or accusing you of things. And so minsan parang feeling mo, Lord, paano ba ito? Nai-stress ako dito. Well, God is encouraging you to pray for space or relief. Just ask God, no? Lord, bigyan mo po ako ng space. Nasasakal ako dito sa sitwasyon na to. Not necessarily removing the person or ikaw mismo maalisin ni Lord doon sa sitwasyon, but maybe in your heart, He would give you relief. Na kahit ganun yung ginagawa ng mga tao or tao na yun, you know, He comforts you and assures you na huwag ka mag-alala. You know, the Lord has set apart the godly for Himself, sabing ganyan. The Lord will hear when I call to Him. So call upon the Lord. Okay? If you are stressed out ngayon because of somebody, call upon the Lord and ask God to give you relief. The second thing na nakita ko dito sa psalm na ito is you can ask God for rescue. And I see that in verses 4 and 5. No? So, basahin natin. Sabi ganyan in verse 4, in your anger, do not sin. When you are on your beds, search your hearts, you know, and be silent. Okay? Sila ulit nakalagay. Offer right sacrifices and trust in the Lord. Now, there is, offer right sacrifices and trust in the Lord. Now, why is he saying that? Actually, you know, when I read it, mukhang ina-address niya yung mga tao na nag-o-oppress sa kanya, no? Sabi niya, in your anger, do not sin. When you are on your bed, search your hearts and be silent. But I believe he's also talking to himself. So sabi niya, offer right sacrifices and trust in the Lord. So bagamat siguro iniisip niya yung mga tao na nag-o-oppress sa kanya, pero he's looking to God, asking God for rescue, no? In other words, sinasabi niya sa Panginoon na, Lord, kahit na na-offend ako, I would not, you know, I would not hurt back, hindi ako gagante, you know, I would put my trust in you, I would be silent. Yun ang sinasabi niya, eh. Imbis na I-express niya yung kanyang galit, no? Sabi niya, Lord, you know, I offer right sacrifices and I trust in you, Lord, na you would deliver me, in other words. Again, this is something that you can pray for. Ask God to rescue you sa situation na yun. Though it may be difficult, He would, vindicate you and prove that you are, ika nga, innocent. So put your trust in God. Now, thirdly, as I meditate on this psalm, nakikita ko na you can ask God for renewal. Pwede ko humingi sa Panginoon ng, you know, refreshment or encouragement sa puso mo, because it can be very discouraging pag may mga taong parang sinisisi ka, ina-accuse ka, and so forth. So, si David was asking God for the renewal of his soul. Ganito ang sabi sa verse 6 and 7. Many are asking, who can show us any good? And then, suddenly, nag-shift yung attention ni David, and he remembers yung sinasabi doon sa Numbers chapter 6, no, yung Aaronic blessing. Sabi, let the light of your face shine upon us, O Lord. And then sabi niya, you have filled my heart, you know, or my soul with greater joy than when their grain and new wine abound. So si David, when he started, you know, looking to the Lord and asking God for help, no, naisip niya na to ask God for renewal. The renewal of his soul, the renewal of his heart. He's asking God to fill him with joy and peace. So tunay nga, when you are sometimes stressed out sa mga tao sa paligid mo, just come to God, you know, and ask God for relief tulad ni David. Lord, bigyan mo ako ng space, ng breathing space. You can ask God for rescue, you know, you can trust the Lord. Lord, hindi ako magagalit, I would not. Hindi ako gaganti. And then ask God for renewal in your soul. You know, that God will restore the joy in your heart. Upang sa ganun, kahit na, you know, nandun pa rin yung situation, dun sa psalm, wala namang indication na umalis na yung mga tao. They seem to be still there, you know, oppressing him. Pero finally, I see in verse 8, this idea na we can ask God for rest. Sabi sa verse 8, I will lie down and sleep in peace. For you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety. I will lie down and sleep in peace. So you can ask God for rest. Kung ikaw ay parang nai-stress out sa mga tao, ask the Lord, Lord, bigyan mo nga ako ng good night, good night's rest. Did you know that you can actually pray for that? Pag hindi ka makatulog? Well, that's what the Bible says. Sabi niya, I will lie down and sleep in peace. For you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety. So you can actually depend on the Lord for a good night's sleep. So, sa madaling salita, if I am to summarize this, no? We can only depend on God with difficult people. Wala tayong magagawa. Sometimes, you know, people are people, so minsan makulit sila and they're hard to relate with. Sa Tagalog, ang Diyos lang ang maaasahan sa mga taong mahirap pakisamahan. Kung may kilala ka mga tao ngayon na parang nahihirapan ka to relate with them, so nai-stress ka, remember these four prayer items. Una, ask God for relief. Ibigyan ka ni Lord ng space para hindi ka, kumbaga, tuloy-tuloy yung stress na yun. You know, by God's grace, He will just give you enough space to recover. Ask God for rescue, you know. Trust the Lord. Huwag kang gumante, huwag kang lumaban, huwag kang magsalita ng masakit. Trust in the Lord. And then ask God for renewal in your heart and spirit. Ask God to give you joy and peace. Ask God to restore your spirit, no? Huwag kang ma-discourage dun sa mga sinasabi ng tao na yun. And then finally, ask God for rest. Ask God for rest. So let the Lord give you a good night's sleep tonight, if that is happening to you. So we can only depend on God with difficult people. Trust in the Lord. Si Lord lang talaga makakatulong sa atin. So if this is your situation tonight, hindi ko alam kung ano na yung nangyayari, but if you're stressed out because of some people, dahil sa mga sinasabi nila, if you feel oppressed, kung may tao man sa buhay mo na parang masakit magsalita ng mga bagay-bagay, you feel na parang unfair and so forth, trust in the Lord. You know, just ask God, Lord, bigyan mo po ako ng space dito. Nasasakal ako. Just ask God for rescue. Ask God for renewal. Ask God for rest. He will hear you. He will hear your prayers. And that's what I want to do at this time. That's what I want us all to do at this time. Bigyan ko muna kayo ng time and space para you can just call upon the Lord before I pray. Call on God. Ask God for relief, for space. Ask God to rescue you, to give you renewal in your heart and soul. Call upon the Lord to give you rest. Dear Lord, I pray for everyone na ngayon ay nakikinig. There may be some na nakaka-relate sila dito sa psalm na ito, Panginoon. Maybe they feel stressed out dahil may mga tao sa buhay nila na nahihirapan sila to relate with. Lord, you know who these people are. And I just pray, Lord God, na you would give them space. Lalo-lalo na kung parang na-pressure na sila, na sasakal na sila because of this constant nagging siguro or constant parang negativity sa mga salita. Lord, give them relief. And rescue them, Panginoon. Let the peace of God just fill their hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Lord, I pray for those na nagsasuffer na sa stress. Palitan mo ito, Lord, ng peace that passes all understanding. At gaya na napag-aralan din namin kagabi, Lord God, release each one from anxious thoughts. Remove our worries and fears and all kinds of concerns, Panginoon. And last but not the least, Father, I pray for each and everyone na nakikinig sa evening prayers na ito. May you give them a good night's rest. May the peace of the Lord just comfort them, relieve their stress, speak love and joy sa puso nila, Panginoon. Hallelujah. Lord, you are more than able to do this. And I pray, Lord, ngayong gabi na ito, as we prepare to sleep, comfort each one, Panginoon, with the presence of your Holy Spirit and with hope. Lord, maraming salamat po, Panginoon. We do thank you and praise you for tonight. For you, O Lord, is our place of safety. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.